Hello everyone, my name is Ever Barbero, and today I'd like to talk about example 6.2 in my textbook, Finite Element Analysis of Composite Materials Using Abaqus. In this example, we illustrate computational micromechanics. You will learn how to calculate material properties for the composite in terms of the properties of the fiber and matrix. We use 3D modeling of a unit cell, also called RVE. You will also learn how to apply periodicity conditions. To build the part, we start with 3D. Solid, extrusion. On the XY plane, we draw a rectangle with dimensions, width times height, of the RVE, and extrude it with a depth equal to the depth of the RVE along the fiber direction. Now we partition the front face of the cell with a sketch of the cross section of the fibers. The radius of the circle is the radius of the fiber. Then we extrude the fibers through the depth of the cell. In module property, we create two materials, fiber and matrix. Now we use the section manager to create sections for fiber and matrix, even though there are no section properties to add for solids, not like we had thickness for shells, cross-section area for rods, and so on. Now we assign the matrix section to the matrix region, and the fiber section to the fiber region. In module assembly, we create an independent instance from the only part we have. Now we create static linear perturbation steps, one for each of the first three columns in the stiffness matrix, so that we can later calculate E1, E2, Nu12, Nu23, and G23. See the textbook for details. Now we edit the field output requests, so that we get what we need for each column, Specifically, we need the integration point volume, which is not saved by default. For each step, corresponding to each column in the matrix equation, we add boundary conditions that are specific for the current step. We apply symmetry boundary conditions on all faces except the loaded one, which effectively provide periodicity conditions for the representative volume element, RVE. Symmetry with respect to the YZ plane. Symmetry with respect to the XZ plane. Symmetry with respect to the XY plane. On the last face, we enforce a displacement. With a value given by the right-hand side of this equation. Now we apply the boundary conditions for column 2. Symmetry with respect to the XY plane. Symmetry with respect to the XZ plane. Symmetry with respect to the YZ plane. Apply a displacement to the remaining face. Now we apply the boundary conditions for column 3. Symmetry with respect to the YZ plane. Symmetry with respect to the XY plane. Symmetry with respect to the XZ plane. Apply a displacement to the remaining face. A quick review, column by column. Now we mesh. As usual, we need a job, then submit it. When completed, click results. To calculate E1, E2, NU12, NU23, and G23, we use a Python script, available on my website. We copy it. Then paste it in the Python shell, down below, switching from messages to Python. And at the end, we can get the results. Okay, that's it for today. If you liked this video, don't forget to subscribe. You can find more details in the textbook, by following the link in the description. Thank you.